airstream that comes in here from Texas. It's been all over this time, late in the afternoon. And another insect that's local is a very tiny blue, pale blue. It's a very tremendous insect. And they lay eggs on the flowers and develop the seeds. And the larvae are really quite small. And they're pretty hard to find, but that's the same host plant for both of those species here. And when I came out here yesterday, there were about 10 of these little blues on here, presumably laying eggs on this plant, and there were a couple of pretty good seeds here as well. There are a lot of different plants in here. Mark, I don't know if part of you told you, but there's something like about 180 different varieties of plants. That means that there's something blooming in here before we get the last frost in the spring and after we get the first frost in the fall. In fact, right behind me, there's a plant here which is pretty extraordinary. It's called Sheffield Pink. It's just getting buds on it right now. That'll be the last thing to bloom in here. And that'll bloom even if we have frost and after frost, and it brings in a tremendous number. So I haven't done a count, but I would guess that there's probably somewhere between 30 and 35 different varieties of plants in bloom here right now. And if you do count here through the summer, that's probably somewhere between 10, 20, 30 different kinds of plants. Some of these plants will bloom continuously. Like Marguerite's standing right beside one here, which is called the Verbena bonariensis. That'll be blooming all virtually all summer. That'll bloom. Frost. Other plants come and go. We've got the tropical milkweed there that's got the orange and yellow flowers. That'll be blooming virtually all summer long as well. This vitis comes on here and it's only good for about 2 weeks. This clover has just come on. That'll probably be done in another 2 weeks. We've got a baptisia here that blooms quite early.